Hey guys, this video will be a makeup video on the mermaid makeup look inspired by my nails, which are mermaid. I did a collaboration with Jessica, who is an awesome TikTok nail tech that I met through TikTok, and it came out that she was actually a subscriber to my channel, so that's pretty awesome, and I really wanted to collaborate with her. So we did this awesome TikTok where we show our nails and makeup. It's really nice. If you guys want to see that, definitely follow my TikTok. I'll leave all that information down below, and I'll also leave her information down below. So first I start off with Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion. I apply this, and then I go in with Pure X Raw Beauty and Christie Palette. I use the more vibrant side. I start off by using Side Effect, which is a hot pink, and I put that in my crease. Then I go in with Tribute, which is this purple you see, and I put in this at the corners of my eyes. I wanted it to be a lot more deep there. And then I go in with Hurtful, which is this really pretty blue, and it's a lot more cool tone blue. So I did realize after I did the whole makeup look, I could have probably used a more vibrant blue, but all in all, it came out really nice. I think that the pink and the purple just work so well together and blended so nicely together that I pulled it through together really nicely. So I put this as the base. Then I'm going to go in with my own glitter mixes that I made. I'll put that link down below on how to make your own pressed glitters and pigments. It's a whole YouTube video where I show you guys the products and everything, and I'm gonna use this purple one. I do use the e.l.f. glue, the glitter glue. It works awesome. I used the brush from AOA Studios. It's only like a buck and some change. Works really, really well. And then just save these little sponges. They work amazing when you apply pigments or glitters to your eye. And then I'm gonna go in with the LA eyeliner. It's one of their Shockwaves neon eyeliner. It is in the color Vivid. It's really nice. I also use it as the base of my lips. Then I'm going to go in with the Morphe eyebrow gel in Java. Probably saying that wrong. And that's the color I use. I thought that would work well with my hair so far. I just put that at the end. But first, I do go in with the Ulta Beauty Sculpting Brow Pencil in dark brown. And I simply just fill in my brows with this. It looks like they're very harsh. They're really not. For some reason on camera, they look very harsh. But I go in just to fill on any missing hairs, and then I do use the Morphe gel brow towards the middle and end of my eyebrow just to get a really nice solid color there. And then you will see me use the ColourPop Brow Boss Gel in color Blonde, and I love this trick. I seen this somebody do it on YouTube. I don't remember who it is, but they use a blonde or way, way brighter, lighter color in the beginning of their eyebrows to kind of not have it look blocky. If you do like that look, go for it, but I personally don't. I like to see my hairs in the beginning to look a lot more transparent, if that makes sense, and then be solid afterwards. Then I go in with my Glassy In Touch Soul Primer. I love this stuff. I put this on even when I don't put on makeup. I love it. It's so hydrating and not oily at all. After that, you will see me go in with my e.l.f. Putty Primer. This stuff is awesome. It just fills in your pores so nicely, and it's very hydrating as well. It doesn't dry up your skin at all, and I have dry, sensitive skin, for those of you that don't know. Then I go in with my favorite thing, which is the Becca Under Eye Brightening Corrector. This stuff is awesome. If you have purple or blue skin tone kind of colors under your eyes or anywhere in your face, this stuff is magic. It is very light, so you don't feel it heavy. And it works best for me personally with a brush. Then I go in with these two foundations, which are full coverage. You can still kind of see my freckles through them, but I really like mixing these two colors because I do live in Texas and my skin tone changes. I get a tan really quick and it lasts a while, and then out of nowhere in the winter I'm pale. So it works really nice to be able to control the amount of color that you want in there, so that way I don't have to be buying 20,000 products. I can just buy two or three and then mix it between those. So I do start off with my Real Techniques brush, and this brush is awesome for foundations. I did get it from Walmart. It is really pretty. The color, of course, caught my eye, the rose gold, but it works great with foundation. And then at the end, I top it off with my Real Techniques sponge because I just feel it completes it. It just sinks everything that's left over in there, and it doesn't look dry or patchy. Your skin looks flawless. It doesn't look dry at all. Like I said, I do have dry skin, so I like to moisturize a lot to make sure that my foundation doesn't look extremely dry, but I also don't like to look oily. So after I do this, I go in with concealer, and I'm going to be using the Infallible Wear Full Wear concealers, and I'm going to be using both the color Cashmere and Biscuit because, like I said, I'm not the greatest at matching anything to my face. So I just like to pick one that I think is mine, and then a lighter and a darker just to have options. And these are awesome. They cover everything under your eyes. They're great for any pimples or any redness around your face. And a little goes a long way. I know it looks like I have a lot, but I've learned that the less is more. The more you put on, the more dry and patchy your makeup can turn out, especially if you have dry skin. And my face just doesn't like to have a lot of makeup on. And if I do, I take it right off. I literally recorded this video and took it off 10 minutes after I was done recording it and taking the pictures that I needed. So, like I said, some people like full coverage, some don't. It's just preference. And I know I do talk a lot. I'm sorry. That's just my videos. It's what I like to do. I go in with the Fit Me Maybelline Fair Light Powder. This stuff is magic, you guys. If you guys have had dry, patchy skin, try this powder. It's very light and fluffy. I really do love it. And try it with the Real Techniques brush, the purple one that I showed you. It's, I think, number 300. It's very airy. Like, it makes your makeup look flawless and not dry at all. So then I go in with this netting tool. I bought this netting tool from, I think, Joann Fabrics store because I use it for nails. That's how I do my mermaid nails, the scales on the nails. And I thought it would work amazing with this. But I did come to realize that it's a little too small. I need something that's a little bit wider. And the netting is a lot bigger so that you can see the scales from afar. If I zoom in, you can actually truly see the scales. But honestly, when you do makeup like this, it's mostly from talking distance, or now with the corona, it's a little bit farther than that. So you can't really see that. You just see eyeshadow on your face. So that's one thing I did notice. This is my first time making this on my face, a mermaid look. I usually am used to doing it on my nails, not on the face. So that's one thing I will tell you. You can use leggings. Like, they have these little, what are they called? They're like the legging netting things. Those would work amazing with this type of look. So I did start off with the blue. I did that first, which is the Hurtful. I put that all around the end of my, like, the corners of my face, to kind of bring it in. And like I said, I probably should have got another more vibrant blue, but look at that blue came out really nice. The ones on my cheek, I don't know, it's because maybe the way I did it came out a little bit more cool tone, which works cool for contouring, but I did want the scales to show a lot more. I did realize that by using Tribute, which is the color I'm using now, and the Side Effect, the hot pink, the scales were visible from far away, a lot more visible than the blue. So that's just some other tricks, you know, that, or advice you can say that I can tell you by doing this for the first time. And another thing is, patting it works best. When you're moving the brush back and forth, you're gonna kind of get the bristles in between the netting, so it's gonna cover, it's not gonna do the outline. The netting basically gives you the shape that you're gonna do. So if you're brushing back and forth, you're gonna get rid of the scales and they're not gonna show as much. So I really, really recommend just patting it lightly on top and using as much powder as you want. You don't have to tap the excess off either, because it'll show more that way. But this is so far the outcome of this. I just didn't know what I was doing here. I just kept going. I was like, you know what? Some pink will look nice here. Some of this will look nice here. But you can definitely try other colors. I just had fun. This was so different than what I'm used to doing. And then I do go in with the pink and do that under my eyes just to help bring in the color that I have on my crease. And this Side Effect color, pink, is really, really nice. It's very vibrant, you guys. It's one of my favorites from her palette. Then I do the eyelash adhesive glue, basically, from Kiss. This is the eyelash glue. It's one of my favorites. I use that, and then I put on my crystals. The crystals I use here, I use for my nails, and I get them from Ally Express, which, if you guys don't know, it's similar to Wish. It does take up to a month to 3 months to get these items, but I do have a ton of videos where I show me applying them to the nails, as well as I do have a real versus fake Swarovski crystals. If you guys want to see that, go ahead and go to my channel and watch it, because I have a bunch of links where you can buy some really inexpensive that look very close to the real ones, especially if you want to play around with them. Now I'm just going back and I'm using the eyeliner, which I know it's not a lipstick or anything like that, but I'm using it as a lip liner, and it's very smooth and creamy. It worked really great as my base. Then I'm going in with Cubest Lip Series. It is a lipstick, matte lipstick that I bought from AliExpress like 5 years ago. It probably doesn't work, and it's probably not healthy for me to put it on my lips, but I only did it for the video because that's the only purple I ever had since I did makeup. So I just went for it. I'm not going to link it because I don't recommend it. It the ingredients are not on there, so I don't recommend you putting it on your face. Like I said, I took it right off as soon as I was done recording and taking pictures. And then I go in with my Milk mascara makeup, and this stuff is awesome. It works really, really nice and natural on your eyelashes. Then here I use the same Kiss glue and I apply it to my fingers, and then I tap it into my cheeks. I don't recommend you doing that, because first of all, the glitter will stay stuck to your finger and it's a pain in the butt to remove from your finger. Second of all, it kind of leaves your eyeshadow patchy. You're removing the product you just applied. Like I said, I've never put glitter, at least this kind of chunky glitter, on my face before, or crystals. So I'm learning as I'm going as well. I do recommend using a brush and patting it gently in the glue, and then going in with another brush to adhere the glitter, so you don't end up with glitter fingers on your face. And this really helped bring out, I feel, the look. I was done after the crystals, and then I saw my nails and I tried to look at how much more I can blend it in, and that's the way it worked. Then I'm gonna go in with my Nano Titanium by Baby Bliss Pro. This stuff is awesome. I really do love it. I do love the color, but it's so, so cool. So it has like three different settings, really tight curls, medium curls, and loose curls. I think I had it on loose medium curls here. Or medium. I think it's medium curls. I don't remember anymore. But you just put it in, you close it, and as soon as you close it, it takes and grabs your hair, and then it beeps. When it starts beeping really fast, it'll stop. It's around 8 to 10 seconds. And by the 10th second, it basically says, okay, it's ready to come out. Then you just open it and it pops out the curls, you guys. If you really curl your hair, I definitely recommend it. This is the final look after applying this and brushing through the curls. I really hope you guys like it. Don't forget to watch my nail video as well. Comment down below and follow me on TikTok and on Instagram. Thanks, you guys. See you on my next video.